You're making a case that climate change, the climate change issue, is a poverty issue. Explain that.
You know, every time I'm in the G20 meetings, I'm asked about things like, what are the downside risks in the economy going forward? And I make the case every single time that climate change is not an issue for our grandchildren. It's an issue today. If we are to have any hope of keeping global warming below 2 degrees Celsius, the peak year of carbon emissions has to be 2016. So the challenge is right in front of us today. If you go to some of the island countries, the president of the Philippines, President Aquino, was at a meeting at the World Economic Forum saying, if any of you doubt the reality of climate change today, please come to the Philippines.
So give me a specific example of an intervention now that the World Bank could help with.
So for example, in Africa, what we know is that the biggest drag on economic development in Africa is access to power, access to electricity. And so we're now trying to come up with a plan that will provide energy for all of Africa, as much as they need, but through sustainable sources. If we can do that, that would be a huge advance. But what we know is, even if we do that, the problem still remains because the United States, Europe, and China are the biggest emitters, and we've got to make progress there. I'm really encouraged by the commitment that leaders in all of those three areas have shown, the Chinese leadership, the U.S. leadership, and the European Union. But we've got to take action. We don't have time to waste.
Commitment, but not a lot of action. So, or at least not a lot of agreement on exactly what should be done by those countries and others.
Yeah, you know, reaching the agreements have been really difficult. It's been a difficult process, and we know that some sort of agreement is needed in order for us to, for example, find a stable price on carbon. You know, this is really critical. We've got to find a way to establish a stable price on carbon. There have been things that have happened, the European Union, these have been setbacks that were very concerning. On the other hand, what we know we have to do is, if when we get a stable price on carbon, market forces will kick in, and that's going to be when we really make dramatic progress.
So what's your role? I mean, do you put money into this, or are you the town crier or the warner, or what are you doing?
Well, let me just tell you three things in which we're directly involved in issues around climate change. The energy issue. We've got to work on increasing access to finance for sustainable energy. So we're doing that right now. Our own sustainable energy portfolio has more than doubled over the last 5 years. Agriculture. You know, agriculture is the only thing that can actually take carbon from the air and put it back into the ground. And there are ways of organizing agriculture that are climate smart. We can reclaim degraded lands. We can use varieties of wheat, for example, that have deeper roots, so that not only do they yield more, but they actually put more carbon back into the ground. We've got to figure out what to do with other greenhouse gases that come from agriculture. Cities. China, when I went to visit with the premier of China, Li Keqiang, he immediately said, we need your help on how we can build cleaner cities. You know, there's a lot of great news around clean cities. Look at what New York did. They're going to reduce their carbon footprint by 30% by 2017, and the original target was by 2030. Look at what's happening in places like New Delhi. All of their buses, all of their little Jeeps and little motorcycles are running on natural gas. So there are things we can do right now and in those areas, and we're going to be aggressive about moving in each of those areas.
Dr. Kim, thank you once again.
Thank you, Peter.
Thank you so much.